play them on the moon. We can play them anywhere. If we play how we play, it doesn't matter where we play. All right? So it's all about the how.
You don't have to strike early. You can wait in this clock and move the ball and push the ball down. Organize your offense and move the ball and trust yourselves. Share the basketball. We'll all work out.
You start playing the right way. You play clutter-free, and you play free because you trust. Every time someone helps, you know your guy's going to be there. When you trust, you play free. When you play free, you can't be beat. It's not about the where. It's about the how.
And they won the last two games to take this 3-2 lead in these NBA Finals. As we remind you, Spanish language version of today's game presented by ESPN Deportes. Use the SAP button on your television. We're set for game six. And they're going to have to re-jump. Didn't let it get to the highest point. As our officials for tonight, Joe DeRosa officiated game one. Kenny Marra and Monty McCutcheon both game two. We'll try it again. And the Lakers in unfamiliar territory, trailing a series for the first time in these 2010 playoffs. But they are back home, where they have been just a terrific home team, not just this year, but in recent years. Kobe Bryant's first shot won't go. Perkins the rebound. Rondo ahead to Garnett. Garnett, nice move inside, and just like that, a quick bucket from the Celtics.
If you're Doc Rivers, that's exactly what you want to see. If you're Phil Jackson, what you don't want to see.
But that pass by Rondo in transition was so much sounder and simpler than game five.
Bryant gets inside. Good aggressive move to the basket to tie the score. We talk about the great home court play of the Lakers. The Celtics, a superb road team. Second best in the regular season behind Dallas. 6-4 in the postseason. Very impressive road record in the playoffs. Rondo gets a nice soft touch. So an assist and a bucket for Rajon Rondo. Here's why you play the regular season, for home court advantage. Will Jackson giving that message to his team. They won 57 games during the regular season. That's why games 6 and 7 are here at the Staples Center. Bynum flips it up and gets it to go. That's a nice sign. Bynum in game 5 played almost 32 minutes. Only had one rebound. Played the minutes but wasn't his active self.
No, Mike, but you make a great point, because if you are a team in this league, your job is to protect home court as Ray Allen knocks down the jump shot. So if you're the Lakers and Phil Jackson, no need to panic. Just come back home and take care of your business.
9-1 in the playoffs. The only home loss was game 2 against the Celtics in the finals. Fisher trying to draw a foul, and he does the job. Fisher gets knocked down. Not only just this year, but the last several years, they've been 29-4 at home in the last 3 years in the playoffs. Boston beat him once in 08. Houston and Denver beat him last year, and the Celtics in game 2 of this series. So Fisher's saying, I want to go to the line. I was shooting. Kenny Marra will hear none of that. He'll take it out. Ray Allen on Kobe Bryant. Artest spots up. Artest shooting struggles continue, but Bynum, the offensive rebound, goes back up. Does not get the roll. Gasol can't finish it. Ball knocked out of bounds. Celtic ball, but a good sign for the Lakers. Bynum already very active in the early going. That's when he says that tearing his knee gives him the most problems, until he gets it up and going a little bit. A little stiff. He's had it drained a couple of times. So important for the Lakers' success.
That's why if you're the Celtics big, you want to make sure you run the floor against Gasol and Bynum. Take advantage of your speed.
Good hawking defense for the Lakers. Rondo puts up a three, way off the mark. That's not the shot that the Celtics want. Bynum looking to Gasol. Another good open look for Artest. Gets that to go. And an extra cheer from the crowd. As Ron Artest, last four games of these finals, shooting just 24% from the field.
The Lakers get so much off of the pick and roll with Bryant. His delivery to Pau Gasol, and then Gasol, a big time pass.
Fisher. Reverse from Fisher. Lakers trying to turn defense into offense. We've seen the Celtics do that quite a bit in this series.
I'll tell you what's impressive, the energy in this building. This is something we're not accustomed to here. There's been a buzz before this.
As Garnett gets inside, misses the banker, Bynum the rebound. Little extra something from the Laker fans. They do not want the season to end tonight. Pass inside, deflected by Garnett. He had five steals in game five. Gets his first of the evening. Pierce spots up for three. Ray Allen, the offensive board, nearly stolen. And it's still Celtic ball.
Mike, and that pass by Rondo to Paul Pierce in the transition three, it was on target. But I don't think many shooters in transition want to shoot off a bounce pass in transition. If you can put that into the air, I think it's a much easier pass to catch and shoot with.
Really makes that much of a difference.
I think you got to read the guy that you're throwing it to, but I agree with Coach. If you're going to make it a bounce pass, then make it go to the point of the chest where it's a chest pass and they can shoot it in there.
Ray Allen off the screen. Too strong. Fisher gets a running start. Fisher lobs it in, but too high for Bynum.
A little overexcited. Well, it's certainly what the Lakers want to see. Fisher, Bynum, Artest already involved, already scoring.
And I would get Pierce involved again right away in pick and roll.
Count it and a foul.
And a chance for a three-point play. The same mistake we watched in the previous ball game. If there's not going to be ball pressure on Rondo, then if you're Derek Fisher, you can't front Ray Allen in this position. All he's got to do is throw it over the top of the defense, and it's too easy. You got to be in tune defensively. The Lakers were not, and Ray Allen going to the line for the possible three-point play.
Last time Ray Allen was at the Staples Center, he set an NBA Finals record by hitting eight threes, scored 32 in the Game 2 victory. Since then, he has really struggled shooting the ball. He's actually missed 18 consecutive three-pointers. He's done other things for his team. As Gasol, nice fake on Garnett. Gasol gets inside and draws the foul. We talk about a lot of different keys, and obviously the Lakers have them, Jeff, but getting him involved offensively, Pau Gasol, might be the most important.
And that's an excellent play by Brian. He brought the second defender. Garnett rotates out, but give Gasol credit. Great shot fake and drive. And you're right, Mike. His importance can't be understated. Because when, you know, if he's in that 20-10 range, they're really hard to beat. He really didn't have a great game five. But as Brian says, hey, you're not going to play great every game. Gasol was due for a bad game, and he had one.
Bill Jackson said before the series the two keys were curtailing Rondo and getting Pau Gasol involved in his post game.
And truth be told, give Kevin Garnett credit. Looked like he was a dead man walking the first two games of this series. I call him the Big Lazarus because he certainly has come alive and responded.
Ray Allen fires away, and there's a three-pointer after missing 18 consecutive throughout games 3, 4, and 5. Allen nails that one.
Great.
He's got 8 points.
Great screen by Garnett there.
Kobe Bryant, the jump shot. It's always fascinating to watch Bryant, how he gets into a game. Does he look to pass? Does he look to score and dominate early? Good balance from the Lakers to start. Rondo trying to get it inside and does. Artest wasn't looking. Perkins blocked by Gasol. Artest comes up with it.
I think if you're Bryant and Rondo guards, you got to take advantage of that matchup.
Try to jam it in. Ball goes right back to him. And Bryant on the putback. Celtics trying to break. Rondo goes right at Artest. Can't get it. Pierce the rebound. We talked so much about Pierce's rebounding as a great indicator of how he'll play on a certain night. Rondo bumped by Fisher. And that should be two on Fisher if they call it on him. So Derek Fisher picks up his second.
I think if you're Kobe and Rondo's defending, you got to slow it down and play one-on-one basketball. Was fortunate there. Another turnover, but got the basketball back and scored. And Derek Fisher picking up his second foul. Body on Rondo. Rondo very wisely throws it towards the hoop, going to the line for two.
Shannon Brown will come into the game. Brown only played 19 seconds in game five.
And actually, Mike, they say that Rondo was not in the act of shooting.
You're right, Mike. This is a very interesting departure. Putting Brown in ahead of Vujicic, who came in game five, and I thought played very well for the Lakers.
Brown had some great great moments last year in the playoffs. Bryant, wanting drive, drills the jumper with a hand in his face, and the Lakers by four. Well, he's going to be able to get his own shot anytime the smaller Rondo's defending.
And they've got to get out of that cross match quicker in transition. They didn't push it that hard where he should have been able or not able to get back.
Another steal on a bad pass. Bryant ahead to Gasol, strides down the lane. Doc Rivers calls out a play as the Lakers have scored eight straight.
Talk about a skilled big man. Bryant threw the ball in the middle of the fast break to Pau Gasol.
Chance of defense is Rondo. Again, on the switch. Shoots over Gasol. Perkins had it, lost it, but he got hit. That's going to be the third team foul as Perkins is still down and shaken up on the play. He must have taken a hard hit. That's one of the toughest guys in the NBA. As head athletic trainer Eddie Lassert goes out to check on him. Bynum picks up the foul. And you see his arms come down on Perkins. Perkins doesn't have great leaping ability, but just so strong, gets good position.
You know, Mike, it actually looked like he's favoring that right knee as he grabbed it on the way down.
Well, Perkins stays down. We'll take a quick break. Lakers up by six. Back in Los Angeles, 5.5 to play in the first. Celtics down by six, but they're more concerned right now with their center, Kendrick Perkins, who had to be helped off the floor after injuring himself, getting that offensive rebound coming down. Again, here's the play, and Mark, you said it. It looked like as he comes down, landed awkwardly on that right knee. So he had to be helped off the floor. You say Perkins, a guy who averages about 6 points, 6.5 rebounds a game, not enormous numbers, but he has an enormous impact on this team, both for his defense and just his toughness out there, and that would be a huge loss. Hopefully he'll be able to come back. It's heartbreaking when you see a player get to this stage, work so hard to get on the final stage, and they're working on him now as Rasheed Wallace checks in.
Well, and their big men do it by committee, so each and every one of them is very important to their overall success.
Rasheed Wallace looking. Brown on Allen. Brown, a good, tall, athletic body on Ray Allen. Picks it back up top. Garnett left wide open. Garnett coming alive, as you mentioned, last couple of games.
And truth be told, they become a better offensive team because now you have to defend Rasheed Wallace and his ability to knock down the jump shot.
And it's important that Rasheed Wallace keep his composure because Perkins' injury looks bad as Bryant takes another three.
11 points in 7 minutes. He's 5 of 6 from the field.
But Rasheed Wallace is one technical away from being suspended for game 7, so he's got to make sure he plays hard and smart.
Not just in yelling at the refs, but also getting entangled in one of those double technicals. Nice pass inside to Garnett. Good adjustment, and gets it to go. Allen and Garnett working the two-man game beautifully.
Yeah, Coach, I got a question because you see all the people talking about Bryant and not trusting his teammates. When a guy is this hot, the same way that he was last ball game, what do they want him to do?
You know, this is the guy who can only win if he wins because some people, as Artest takes a very difficult shot, he can only win if he wins because some media critics in particular just don't want to give this guy the credit that he is due as one of the all-time greats and all-time big winners.
Pierce jump shot. This is Rondo battling for the rebound, but Gasol takes it away. Lakers have made their last 8 shots from the field. Gasol, Artest off the fake. And Garnett the rebound, but a loose ball foul is going to go against Boston. Rasheed Wallace with his first, third team foul against the Celtics.
I tell you what, in game 5, I didn't like the way that Ron Artest came out. Didn't look like he was into it. He's into the ball game tonight. Paying attention on the defensive end, offensively looking aggressive, looking to take his own shots. This is the Ron Artest that the Lakers need that will give them a legitimate chance to win 2 ball games.
Tony Allen comes in for Ray Allen. Artest inside, stripped, lost, and then a foul. Good job from Rasheed Wallace. They call a foul on Artest. And that's his first. And the Lakers with their 13th foul.
Can I just go back to Bryant?
Sure.
For once? If he had the a different personality where he tried to suck up to people and was warm and cuddly all the time, not one person would have commented that it wasn't a great game five performance. Because when LeBron James scored 25 and beat Detroit, everybody raved about how he carried a team. Or when Jordan used to get 50s in a playoff game, about his greatness. They're talking about trust after that type of game. That's a joke.
Artest spots up, hits a three on Artest. So cold for the past four games. Hits a couple of threes, and the Lakers up by 10.
And again, Pau Gasol making the extra pass.
Rondo gets inside, wild shot won't go. Bryant tips it around. Here come the Lakers. Brown has it stripped on Artest. Seems to be everywhere in the early going. Rondo now on Bryant, shot clock down to 5. Tough fall away. And Pierce on the rebound. Paul Pierce, the floater, and good soft touch from Pierce, who's coming off that 27-point game after his team fell behind 2-1 in the series. Back-to-back strong games for Pierce, who's back home. Los Angeles native who grew up a huge Laker fan, trying to beat the Lakers and win a championship here in his hometown. Gasol doubled and gets hit. And we'll have a timeout. Kobe Bryant, a superb start.
Well, that's just great pull-up basketball. Very good balance. And then got a garbage basket after his shot was blocked. And then centered the ball to Pau Gasol. Gasol, Phil Jackson calls him the best middleman on the break on the Lakers. Lakers off to a great start, up 8.
Back in Los Angeles. With just under 2 minutes remaining, here are the first. Lakers lead the Celtics 26-18. Let's listen into some huddles.
Everything we're doing is too slow, all right? Let's pick our pace up, okay? And we got to make the extra pass on offense. All of them. Hey, guys, we're going to do it together, right? All right? We just need to trust each other.
Defensively, don't chase the ball. Get back.
Bryant off to a great start. Ron Artest, just as important, is Kobe Bryant getting some help. And his teammates struggling, especially in game five offensively. But Ron Artest has 8 points to add to Bryant's total. Len Davis is coming in for the first time. Now for the Celtics, Lamar Odom coming in. That would be the next thing the Lakers would love to see, is get Lamar Odom on track. He has really struggled in these finals after a great conference finals against Phoenix.
And the thing I don't think Lamar Odom is concentrating enough on, as Allen deflects the pass to Bryant, is his rebounding. This guy should be a premier double-figure rebounding player if he's getting 30-plus minutes a game.
We get word Kendrick Perkins having x-rays done right now. As soon as we get any information on the injury, we'll pass it along. Spinning up and under, can't finish. Wallace rips down the rebound. Nate Robinson getting his first minutes. The Celtic bench has played a huge role in these finals. Whether it's big minutes or limited minutes, they've done their job. Nice ball fake from Pierce. Pass deflected by Bryant. He is first team All-NBA defense as well. Test drives inside. He got away with the travel, but Gasol, the offensive rebound. Pau Gasol spinning. Gets it to go. How about Gasol? 5 points, 6 rebounds, and 3 assists here in the opening quarter.
And I think the difference is we're watching him catch the basketball in better position to make his move.
Pierce being chased by Artest. Artest, he goes hard to the basket. Can't finish. Davis kept it alive, but Bryant comes out of the pack. Lakers in game five, their lowest point total of the playoffs, where they only scored 86 points, shot just 39%. And what a different team here. Wallace does a good job backing off, pulls the chair out from under Gasol.
Too many times, though, guys have not run on the floor in transition for Boston. Now, this is the last shot of the quarter opportunity, but you've got to consistently run the floor.
Lakers do not have a foul to give here in the final seconds. Nate Robinson lost the handle, tried to get it back, and that ends the first quarter. A terrific one for the Los Angeles Lakers. 11 for Bryant, 8 for Artest. They shoot 60% from the field. I don't know if this means anything, but the team that has led after the first quarter of these finals have won all 5 games. First quarter complete. Kendrick Perkins back getting x-rays. And the Lakers lead the Celtics by 10.
Welcome back to Los Angeles with Doc Rivers. I know you've talked an awful lot about Kobe and his scoring streaks. What can you live with defensively?
Well, not that. I can tell you that because it was Kobe, Artest, Gasol. They got every 50-50 ball. Offensively, we're not sharing at all. So we have to play better basketball than we did in the first quarter.
Doc, thank you. Mike? Thank
you. Only so much you can do in guarding Kobe Bryant, Doris. Lakers going right to Bryant. He's aggressive early, Mark.
Well, ideally, coaching against Bryant, you want to make him a volume scorer. So he's going to get his, but make him shoot a lot in order to get him. This is too easy for Bryant. Able to knock down shots, put the ball on the floor, take advantage of mismatches because you don't get back, not paying attention to detail. And when Bryant has it going this way early, you're in for a long night.
Overall for the series, he's averaging just over 30 a game. Have the Celtics done, though, a pretty decent job against him, Jeff?
Oh, very good. There's only so much you can do with some of the shots he has made. Now, some of tonight are too easy. But in game five, some of those shots were just all-world shots that were also well defended.
The defense from Odom, shot clock winding down. Allen kicks it out. Wallace puts up the three. Can't get it to go. Odom the rebound.
I like what the Lakers did defensively that trip. Switch to pick and roll, so Vujicic on Glenn Davis at the top of the key. You can live with that. And Lamar Odom forcing Ray Allen away.
Vujicic just in the game. Knocks down a two-pointer. So Vujicic, Farmar, and Odom, three of the bench players on the floor now as the lead's up to a dozen. Ray Allen, that's a two. And Allen's found the mark from the perimeter. 4 of 6 from the field.
Hey, but Boston's formula is simple. Defend and rebound. They're not doing either so far, and you've got to give the Lakers credit.
Crushed on the boards right now, 13-5. And we've talked throughout the series, the team that's won the rebounding numbers has won all 5 games. Farmar, the runner. Bynum tried to tip it, knocked out of bounds by Davis. So many X factors. Davis has been one for the Celtics. Odom always won for the Lakers. Odom, quick catch and shoot. An active Lamar Odom. Ray Allen right now, the only starter in the game. Terrible pass for Robinson. Having a tough decision whether to shoot or pass that one. Odom finds Bynum as the trailer, and he got fouled. That's going to be 2 on Rasheed Wallace. It's before the shot. So they'll take it out of bounds. And, of course, if the Lakers win tonight, Game 7 will be Thursday night back here at the Staples Center on ABC. Tip off shortly after 9 Eastern. And then the busy NBA summer continues. June 24th, the NBA draft on ESPN. This crowd fired up from the start. They're not always the most raucous crowd, but they were, Mark, as you mentioned earlier. Odom inside, can't finish. Tied on the rebound. Back up, blocked by Davis. Odom keeps it alive, and Nate Robinson comes down with it. And a foul called on Vujicic.
Mike, you talk about the crowd, and I think the reason why is because there was a sense of urgency. All of a sudden, their backs are against the wall, and they're trying to cheer their team on early and often.
Lakers haven't lost two straight home games during the playoffs since 2000, when Portland beat them two in a row. Glenn Davis, Bynum contests that shot. Bynum much more active here in game six. And a reversal in terms of the shooting from last game. Alley-oop to Bryant. And it's going to be Bryant felt there should have been a foul as Davis and Allen converged on him.
See the overplay, the right play by Kobe Bryant trying to go back door, but great job by Glenn Davis coming over and helping.
Nate Robinson and Glenn Davis, a big part of that game four victory. And the Boston bench won it the fourth quarter. Shot clock down to five. Wallace can't get it to go. Laker defense has been excellent here in the opening half. Odom on the drive, goes at Wallace, blocked, but a foul. Wallace is upset. He's got to be careful as he picks up his third. As Jeff mentioned, he has six technicals in the playoffs, one more, and he'd be suspended for the next game, which would be a game seven if they have it.
You see Lamar Odom puts the ball on the floor in attack mode and certainly got the left arm of Odom as he was going in for the layup. There's no question about that. Did get the basketball, but there was contact. But you like this Lamar Odom the way he's playing. Active on the defensive end and pick and rolls, rebounding the basketball, and not just standing around offensively, using his skills.
And the negative is that Wallace is in foul trouble. The positive to me for the Celtics is Garnett back in the game earlier than he normally comes back in. I'm not sure they can win on the road here in game six or seven, him playing 34, 35 minutes. I think he's going to have to give a 40, 42-minute throwback performance.
Odom knocks it down. The Lakers by 14. With the two Allens, Garnett, and Big Baby. Just over 3 minutes gone by here in the second. Nice pass inside to Ray Allen. Rajon Rondo picking up his third assist. Rondo had that terrific finish in game two. Ray Allen started it, Rondo finished. The Lakers' only home loss of these playoffs. Gets up on Farmar. Inside to Odom. Odom flips up a shot. Bryant nearly tips it in. Gets the rebound back up. Doesn't get the bounce. Fight for the rebound, Davis. Ray Allen off to a good start. Rondo tried to jam it in there. Bad pass. Ball poked loose. Farmar dives on it. Throws it ahead to Bryant. Bryant to the basket. And he's fouled. Kobe Bryant will shoot two. Terrific hustle by the Lakers. They're an energetic team here in the first half of game six as they face elimination.
We gave Rondo love when he made this type of play. Well, how about Jordan Farmer? Willing to sacrifice his body, keeping the play alive. Outstanding hustle from Farmer.
History of the NBA, including two Hall of Fame broadcasters, the statue outside the Staples Center
the late Chick Hearn. Chick Hearn and Johnny Most as much a part of the history of these franchises as any player. You ask any fan who've been a long time Laker or Celtic fans, and their voices meant so much, so many growing up with the great calls of two Hall of Famers.
I have to say this. Did you see the transition defense by Mark Jackson on the Shaq highlight? You talk about waving the white flag. He wasn't getting in front of the big daddy.
Are you serious? My main assignment on that transition was stopping the ball, which was Bryant. I did my job.
Oh, what a great teammate. Pointing the finger, throwing Austin Crozier and an unnamed other teammate under the bus.
The lead is now 13. Yeah, just over 4 minutes gone by here in the second. Here's Barnett. Rondo and Allen in. Barnett short. Good defense from Gasol.
But Garnett got fouled. He got walked up under by Gasol on his jump hook attempt.
He's trying to sell that to Joe DeRosa right now, Jeff. They call the foul on Big Baby. It's his first. Kobe Bryant gets his first rest.
And not only that, but he leaves the floor and tells Ron Artest, continue to do what we're doing.
See, that's good defense by Gasol, because if you don't jump, you can walk under. Not legally, but it's rarely called. But Garnett has a legitimate beef with that non-call.
Gasol wants the ball. Huge height advantage on Davis. Farmar the drive. Nice move inside. Jordan Farmar. He's going to spark off the bench. 15-point lead.
If you're a guy coming in off the bench, there's no place like home for a big ball game. You see the difference in the benches on the road and at home.
You saw the numbers there. 8-0 start for the Laker bench. Vujicic. That's a two-pointer. In and out. Gasol running the floor. A different Laker team here in game six. They're up by 17.
And a different Celtic team. Not nearly as aggressive.
Timeout, Boston. A 22-7 edge in rebounding.
Not just bench guys, but how about the big guy going coast to coast? Look what I found. Catches the basketball and lays it in. And Jordan Farmar, spectacular off the bench. Not settling for jump shots, getting into the seams. Tough, tough laying. And Bryant saying, that's what I'm talking about, baby. We're headed for a game seven.
I did not. But he knew they had to get back here.
Garnett, tough shot. Rondo almost had it. Artest the rebound.
See the shots the Celtics are getting. They're going away from the paint area. Tough, tough shots and solid defense all half long by the lake.
Odom jump shot. Garnett with his first rebound. The rebound numbers are staggering to start. 23-8 in favor of the Lakers. Pierce on the pull-up. Rattles around. Davis the rebound. Back up. Blocked for the foul. Let's listen to a Doc Rivers huddle.
They're playing harder than you guys. All right? And we're going too fast. We're not making the next pass. Trust each other. We got plenty of time, but we can't wait. We got to go get it, all right? You got the whole game in front of you, all right? Just trust each other.
You know, Mike, I really love that. The reason why is because you get Celtic fans or Laker fans or sports fans that think they're getting referees are not giving up the calls and things aren't going well, and they look for an excuse. Doc Rivers is saying, hey, they're outplaying us. They're playing harder than us, and they're getting it done. We've got to find a way to turn it around. No excuses. Give the Lakers credit. They've come prepared, and they've dominated this first half.
You always expect the team that loses the previous game in a series comes out with a little more desperation. That was certainly going to be the case for the Lakers facing elimination. Now can the Celtics match it after putting themselves in a 17-point hole?
And that's where people misunderstand adjustment. There's no great tactical adjustment today. This is an effort adjustment by the Lakers and by the Celtics, who are playing like they have a cushion of a one-game lead.
Gasol, tough runner across the lane. Not his normal shot. Garnett tracks down the rebound. Paul Pierce gets it going. Nice move from Pierce. Good hard drive to the basket for his second field goal.
And I love that play by Rondo. Hit him in stride where he could catch and attack.
Gasol up top. Vujicic straight on three. It's good. Sasha Vujicic. Couple of buckets here in the first half.
People don't understand how tough that is to come off the bench and to stay ready, not knowing when you're going to be called.
Pierce on the drive. Stripped. Over to the head to Farmar. Farmar inside. Oh, what a finish. 20-point lead for the Lakers. And the bench has been superb for Los Angeles. They've outscored the Celtic bench 13-0. Pierce answers right back. And that's what he did in Game 5 when Kobe Bryant was going off on that brilliant 19-point stretch in the third quarter. He had a couple of big baskets. Pierce answered them back. And Phil Jackson will call a time. But he's got to be thrilled with the way his team has come out to fight here in Game 6.
Great defense turning into spectacular offense. Jordan Farmar throws it down. The Taft High School product. Let him know.
ESPN's presentation of the
Game 6 from Los Angeles. Lakers with an 18-point lead. What a difference from their loss in Game 5 in Boston. They had a playoff low. 86 points, shot just under 40% from the field. So much better here tonight in Game 6. Meanwhile, let's check in with Doris Burke.
Mike, I remain back here near the Celtics locker room. After injuring his knee in the first period, Kendrick Perkins remains back here. He has undergone an x-ray to that injured right knee, but there is no change in status. We do not know yet whether he will return. One of the toughest guys in the Celtics uniform. When he went down and stayed down, you knew that it was not good for the Boston Celtics. But again, an x-ray has been done. There is no change in his status. We do not know yet whether he is available for the second half, Mike.
Had to be helped off as Doc Rivers will have to go to his bench with the likes of Glenn Davis and Rasheed Wallace. But Wallace picked up three quick fouls, so he's on the bench right now. And Josh Powell is coming in. Both guys going to their benches early. And for Josh Powell, this is his first appearance of the NBA Finals. He's only played 32 total minutes in the entire playoffs. Artest steps back, hits a two on Artest. 10 points here in the first half for Artest, who hasn't been able to hit anything over the last couple of games. Pierce gets it inside. Rondo, oh, fancy move, but he couldn't finish. Bryant, Artest steps back to three. There, save Ron Artest in the zone. If he hit that one,
it's safe to say it. He's in his zone on both ends because he's playing stellar defense against Pierce.
Garnett misses. Davis couldn't hold on to the rebound. And Celtics ball.
I mean, you got to give Artest credit. Looked awful the last ball game, over dribbling in this situation, but he's staying aggressive. He's not waiting for Kobe Bryant to make a play and find him. He puts the ball on the floor and knocks down another jumper.
But let me just say, we are waiting on the result to see if that's a good shot. That's a horrible shot. Because, like you said, as Sheldon Williams misses the dunk, he's over-dribbling. If he had missed that shot, people would have said that's an awful shot.
Drives the other way, drives on Pierce, goes to the basket, banks it in. Tough drive. And this right now is the largest lead of the finals by either team. A 22-point cushion right now for the Lakers. Its feet chanting defense, and the defense has been superb. Shot clock down to one. Garnett just gets it off in time. And Brian upset, says it was his ball.
The reason why is because he went for the gamble instead of staying in front of Garnett. Paid the price for the gamble. Gave Garnett a wide open look.
Fisher back in. He picked up two quick fouls. Nice whip pass to Artest. Now left open. Garnett the rebound. Called. Lakers not in the penalty.
Bryant's nearly unstoppable in semi-transition. Here crossed over. Very good defense by Paul Pierce, but that little extra hang and the ability to make tough shots is what bailed him out.
And you give the referees credit, because that looked like it could have been called a foul, but it wasn't a foul. Just a great job of not fouling by Pierce and a tough shot by Bryant.
Gasol on Garnett. Fisher looking to help. Back out Allen. One dribble. Allen handed his face. Can't get it to fall. Tipped out of bounds. Last touch by Gasol. Reminder, amazing is being here. Season tickets for 2010-2011 on sale now. Go to NBA.com/tickets. Reserve your seats. The NBA, where amazing happens. This rivalry has been amazing over the years. This is the 12th time the Celtics and the Lakers have met in a championship round. Celtics have won 9 of the first 11.
Mike, you probably people say, why is Josh Powell in the ballgame? And you're Phil Jackson. You're trying to make sure that if it's a game 7, I'm not going to throw him in for the first time. So if I can steal some minutes and give him some rhythm, I'm going to do it while I'm blowing him out.
And a jump ball Garnett on top of Fisher. Fisher a little shaken up, so they'll have a jump ball. Fisher, of course, won a jump ball against the bigger opponent last time.
And it was KG that he won the jump ball against.
Eric Fisher, so many big games. You look at Fisher and Kobe Bryant. They both played 14 years in the NBA. 7 of those 14 years, they've been to the NBA Finals. Half their career finishes in the championship round, both looking for their 5th championship ring. And Doc Rivers will call a 20-second timeout before the jump ball. We'll take a quick break. 2:17 left in the second. It's been all Lakers. Up today. 2:17 remaining until halftime. Lakers by 20. 2:17 remaining until the T-Mobile halftime report. Stuart Scott, Magic Johnson, Michael Wilbon, and John Barry. They'll analyze the first half, and then you'll get an NBA Finals all-access pass. Some good stuff coming up with the guys as they're ready to go in halftime. Fisher and Garnett. Monty McCutcheon making sure his foot doesn't go over the line. Garnett wins that one. Allen, quick catch, release, three-pointer short. Allen finally broke his streak at a couple of threes early. He's got 13 points to lead the Celtics, but they are getting pummeled here in the first half. Bryant. And the ball stripped, knocked out of bounds. Good help defense. Good double team.
Well, one thing we haven't talked about is a team like the Celtics watching their anchor defensively and Kendrick Perkins go down. That can take the life out of you. Take some time to regroup.
Very popular player with his teammates. Allen this time on the drive gets it into Rondo. Tried to jam it. And couldn't finish that one as Odom comes the other way. Odom with 5 rebounds here in the first half.
What's the low score in a half in NBA Finals?
We'll get our man Dave Fried on it. There's the ball. Another held ball, so they'll jump it up with 1:32 remaining.
I mean, that's a makeable shot. And they've had some makeable shots, but this is a great defensive response by the Lakers.
Now, I like what Lamar Odom did on that play. Realizing he was defended by Rondo, says forget about the triangle offense.
I'm going to put them on my back, and I'm going to be aggressive. Trying to get position. Guys getting a little stubborn. I think they call that play to Jeff Van Gundy. Kobe Bryant just said to Pierce, come on, stop it now. Now, Pierce has the right behind there, as does Gasol have the right to have that first spot where he is. Lakers win the tip. The shooting Celtics, as Rondo has it. Garnett. Walton is in the game. Pass inside Williams. And Williams is fouled. Derek Fisher upset that that's going to be Derek Fisher's third foul. So Fisher's only been able to play 9 minutes here in his first half because of foul trouble. 29 points for the Celtics with 118 remaining. They're shooting just 34% from the field. Answer to your question, Jeff. Lowest points in a half in a finals game, 23. Back in 98, Utah had just 23 points against the Chicago Bulls.
With Stockton, Malone, and Hornacek?
Yep.
Wow.
Hard to believe.
They were going up against a great defense. So.
You can't make any excuses for scoring 23 points. Come on.
That's great defense. So Scottie Pippen was the best perimeter help defender that I've ever seen.
23 points, man.
I hear you.
Walking on Pierce. Pierce trying to draw the foul. Again, they converge on him. Odom wrestles it away. You heard Doc Rivers say it. All the 50-50 balls. Vujicic, a knuckleball.
You see how many yellow jerseys are around when there's penetration by the Celtics. That's getting it done defensively, collectively.
And then they're first to the floor tonight. Lamar Odom was right on top of that. He stopped him, and then he got the loose ball and ignited the transition opportunity.
Ball, Pierce hits the jumper. Pierce 4 of 8 from the field, 49-31.
These are the situations where Bryant loves to get a quality shot for a 2-for-1 situation.
Gasol flips it up. He rushed it. He thought he got hit. Rondo ahead to Sheldon Williams. Now Williams throws it off of Luke Walton. Still Boston ball.
And, you know, if you're Pau Gasol, don't look for a foul. Passive move. You've got to make a big-time aggressive move, and then the referees will call a foul. That's not a foul. That's just a bad play offensively.
Pierce spots up for three. Can't get it to go. Williams couldn't corral the rebound. Kobe Bryant here in his first half. Not only the game's leading scorer is 15, he's got 7 boards as well. Crowd getting on its feet. It's about a 3.5-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Bryant turns, forces it up. Banker won't go. Tipped up and in. Lamar Odom with a strong first half. Final seconds. That'll count if it goes. Off the mark. And a dominant first half comes to an end. The Lakers by 20, and their bench a huge part of this first half explosion. And the Celtics go back to the locker room after getting out-rebounded, out-worked, and out-hustled. 51-31. The Lakers in front. Kobe Bryant at 15 plus 7 rebounds. He's with Doris.
Kobe, how much of the difference in your team is tactical adjustments versus attitudinal adjustments?
Oh, yeah, it's a little bit of both. You know, they play extremely well. They played with a lot of effort in the last 2 home games, and you know, it's important for us to do the same.
Ron Artest looks like a completely different basketball player. Why?
Well, you know, with him, it's such a rhythm thing. You know, he's sometimes he thinks a little too much, throws his game off, you know, instead of just coming out and just playing.
It's never a rhythm thing with this guy. He's always got it, Mike.
He certainly did in the first half, Doris, but he had some help. Ron Artest in double figures with 10. Pau Gasol also
Well, it's 7 points, 8 rebounds, and 5 assists. And we'll have the T-Mobile halftime report coming up after the break with Stewart, Magic, John, and Michael. They'll analyze the first half and some all access during these NBA finals as the Lakers trying to make sure these finals go to a seventh game. First half, they're off to a good start, including out-rebounding the Boston Celtics by an incredible 30-13. And the bench outscoring the Celtics bench 15-0. Halftime of Game 6, Lakers by 20. The Chinese Theater in Los Angeles as we welcome you back. Halftime of Game 6 from the Staples Center. The Lakers with such an impressive performance, 51-31. They're well-represented Hollywood. Glenn Frey, always here. Christina Aguilera, who sang the national anthem tonight. Legendary music producer Rick Rubin and Anthony Kiedis of the Red Hot Chili Peppers. And Diddy and Snoop Dogg, all here at the Staples Center. As we welcome you back to halftime, we're the Diddy and Snoop Dogg of the broadcast. Sorry, I couldn't resist. Welcome back to halftime. Again, the Lakers, just unbelievable how they came out. You expected them to come out with such force, but just even more impressive than in many ways. And Kobe Bryant, as usual, led the way.
He was, again, very efficient and economical in his shots. 6-for-12 from the field. More paint shots than he's had in a long time.
And there's the Coors Light cold, hard look.
Starts it out early. A little short 17 action. He gets a little hand back and is able to get all the way to the rim, which we haven't seen. And then, sensing the mismatch over Rondo, hits the tough pull-up. And then, are you kidding me? Three. And then again, semi-transition, double clutch over Pierce. And then giving it up, not to get an assist, touches it to Gasol. Rotation by Pierce. Gasol, who's an outstanding passer, hits Ron Artest right in his shooting pocket. And you look at this shot chart, and it tells the tale of Kobe Bryant living in the paint. 6 of his 12 shots right at the basket area.
And Bryant leading the way scoring-wise, but he had his help. And our Windows 7 winning combination is about his teammates and just the overall effort of the team.
Well, what you don't want to do as a head coach in this league is force to coach energy, effort, and passion. That's the difference with the Lakers. You're talking about all-out hustle. Jordan Farmer hits the deck. Loose ball keeps it alive for Bryant. How about extra effort plays? Again, Derek Fisher selling out his body. Hustle play again. Jump ball with Fisher and Garnett because of the energy, effort. And how about this one? Pau Gasol at half court as the ball is in the corner. Does not give up on the play. Sprints to the paint area, and look what I found. Lays it in because of his energy, his passion, and that will get you a game 7.
Let's send it over to Doris Burke.
Mike, Doc Rivers telling me that Kendrick Perkins, after injuring that right knee in the first period, is definitively out for the rest of the day. They will reevaluate him. Here is the injury that he suffered in the first quarter to that right knee. They will reevaluate him for a game 7. As it relates to strategic adjustments, he simply said, LA played harder. They seem to out-rebound us at a pace that we simply cannot win if they dominate the glass that way. Their ability to score the basketball prohibited them from getting into the running game. I don't think there was a thing he was pleased about, guys.
No, rightfully so, Doris. And you saw in that replay Perkins pointing to his knee right away. Again, it just breaks your heart. He's one of our favorite players because of how hard he plays all the time. Doesn't worry about stats, just wants to win. And you hope that the injury is not that severe, where he'll be able to at least play in a game 7 if that's necessary. Pierce falls, gets back up. Rondo struggling with his dribble. And a foul on Fisher. Fisher can't believe it. That's 4 fouls in 9 minutes.
Like, very, very interesting as we take a look at what the Celtics have done all night long, really. Ray Allen started off on fire, but nobody has carried them on the offensive end. These three guys, the rest of the team, 1 for 14 from the field. Interestingly enough, Doc Rivers decides to go with Glenn Davis starting this half. You talk about the size of Gasol and Bynum. They ought to love that matchup.
That's the exact opposite a lot of the numbers from game 5. Ray Allen can't get it to go. Davis trying to keep it alive, nearly does. Remember, the Celtics shot 56% from the field in game 5.
And here tonight, 33%. We said at the top, Lakers are a much different team as Bryant draws the foul. They're just a different team here at the Staples Center. Phil Jackson, that's what he said after the Game 5 loss. One of the ways they kept it positive for them in the locker room. Hey, we're going home. That's where we're at our best. All we need to do is do just win one game, and then we'll get a Game 7 again on our home floor. Artest tried to jam it in there. Ball deflected. Now, Laker fans are certainly aware of comebacks. Nice pass inside. Davis misses the layup. Back out Allen. Here's everybody remembers Game 4 of the 2008 Finals. Well, the Celtics were down 24 in the first half, down 20 with 6 minutes to go in the third quarter. Came back and won Game 4 of that Finals. Went up 3-1 and clinched it in Boston. So if there's any kind of run by the Celtics, certainly a lot of the fans will be thinking of those days. Lakers have continually said, though, they're a different team than 08. Tonight is their chance to prove it. Gasol off the mark. Pierce the rebound.
Bad offense by the Lakers. Guys standing around right now as opposed to moving the basketball and having man movement. Still Boston ball.
When you're a coach, Jeff, and you're down huge numbers like that at halftime, what's the message that you give them as they're coming out here to start the third?
Well, I think what you're trying to do is chip away as Lamar Odom comes in early for Bynum. Chip away, try to work it down to a manageable number by the start of the fourth. 10, 11, 9, somewhere in there where you have a legitimate chance at winning the game.
Mark at the other end for a team you're up a huge number. The tendency so often is to relax as Rondo can't hit. Maybe with a rebound on the foul, but you'd hope nobody be relaxing in our finals game.
What you realize is there are times when you have a big lead and guys all of a sudden get out of character and trying to do something they're not capable of doing or just thinking it's time to freestyle. No, it's time to continue to execute and prepare for what will work when it matters most.
That foul on Gasol is first. Kevin Garnett now gets in his double team. Tough shot from Garnett. Ball knocked out of bounds. He'll go the other way.
But I like Glenn Davis's effort on the board. They got pounded as you see Andrew Bynum go back into the locker room.
Right now we have Kobe Bryant and Glenn Davis talking to each other, challenging one another. If you're Glenn Davis, you better be careful.
I'd go at Shannon Brown if I was Glenn Davis.
Bryant on the double team. Bryant had that hot start. Artest inside to Gasol. Gasol turn. Good double team from Pierce. And the Celtics force a turnover. Ray Allen goes right at Shannon Brown. Misses the layup. That's three missed layups by the Celtics already here in the third quarter. Been nearly 3 minutes. Lakers still without a point here in the third. Odom ends that. Good solid game for Odom. 8 points and 6 rebounds.
Coach, you've talked about it time and time again. This is when they're extremely tough to beat, when Lamar Odom is playing with confidence and aggression.
Garnett inside. Oh, tough shot. Rondo.
Oh, he does that against the trees.
Terrific angle.
And I think Odom is so versatile that sometimes he's too in tune with trying to always be a playmaker. This guy can score and rebound and has to always be aggressive because he will make the right play with the pass.
Gasol hits the shot. Although Phil Jackson, he said it again the other day, he always talks about that he wants him to view himself as a playmaker when he's out there.
Yeah, but great players who pass naturally, and Doc Rivers said this in this series about Garnett, they're going to pass when that play comes about. But they can become too passive as scorers if they think pass too often.
Donna Brown getting some extra minutes here in Game 6 with the foul troubles to Derek Fisher. Ball nearly turned over. Odom couldn't hold out of it. And it's Laker ball with 8 on the clock. Doc Rivers felt it should have been Celtic ball. We'll Brothers trying to urge his team on right from the start. Lakers came out with a four. Celtics have not been able to answer. They've been out rebounded by 17 thus far. Artest in and out. That one halfway down. Ball Pierce spots up for three. And Pierce gets that one to go. And it's 55-38.
Mistake defensively by the Lakers. What you don't want to do is take your foot off the gas pedal and allow the Celtics to get some life, especially Pierce, Allen, and Garnett. They can carry them to a great run.
Allen gets right up into Kobe Bryant, trying to draw the foul. The spin inside to Gasol. Gasol can't finish. Ball kicked out of bounds. Last touch by the Celtics. Boston, much better defensive start here in the second half.
Their energy's been great. And if they had converted a couple of those easy layups, you'd have been talking already about this lead being at 15 or 13.
Garnett and Gasol really battling down low. Bryant on a drive, gets the contact, count it, and a foul. Kobe Bryant with a chance for the three-point play.
Just a great read. Rather than trying to rise above KG, takes it to his body. So you eliminate his jumping ability. Goes straight to his chest. Grown man move and the finish. Bryant going to the line for the three-point play. But this is a big-time move.
And hearing the chants of MVP from the crowd. Bill Jackson talking the other day about Kobe Bryant, saying how was his drive and energy night after night was just unmatched. How hard he plays every single night. In addition to all the skill. Lead back up to 20. We play 5 minutes here in the third. Pierce the drive. Trying to draw contact. Tough shot for Pierce.
And that's how they started game five, which is as Garnett flops, as Pierce going pick and roll.
Shannon Brown misses. And Rondo trying to push. Get a little physical, as expected. Pierce dribbles it off his foot, trying to draw a foul. Bryant to Brown!
What a great job by Pau Gasol. Didn't quit on the play, hustled back, got the ball pierced, and forced a turnover. Then looked at him afterward.
Pierce thought he got hit and stayed on the ground as the Lakers get the easy opportunity. Garnett answers at the other end.
And Gasol thought Pierce intentionally tripped him, and I think that's why he stared at him.
But you appreciate that toughness if you're the Lakers. That's the type of toughness you're going to need.
Gasol having a good bounce-back game after a subpar effort in game five. We're past the midway point here in the third. Pau Gasol leans in, left-handed, rolls off, and Davis the rebound. Garnett shoots over Odom. His 36% shooting from the field for Boston as Kobe Bryant just grabbed his eighth rebound. And Phil Jackson will call timeout.
Pau Gasol moving his feet very well. Forced the turnover. Bryant gives it up to Shannon Brown. Man, he was up.
ESPN's presentation of the NBA.
Third quarter at the Staples Center. Game six of the 2010 NBA Finals. Lakers trying to force a game seven. And right now in complete control as they lead it 60-42. Andrew Bynum, you saw him go back to the locker room. He just tweaked his knee a little bit, much like he did earlier in the series. So they worked on a bit. Put some ice. He's back on. He still can come back in the game. Not the case with Kendrick Perkins. Sprained knee. Shannon Brown! We've seen him at times with some of the most explosive dunks in the league. And he does it again here. Wasn't the greatest pass,
But boy, did he handle that. That's great preparation coming out of the timeout, too. You talk about Phil Jackson. This is a design play. Pau Gasol puts it away from him. But what can Brown do for you? Jump out the building and finish. Make you look good. My goodness. The type of plays I made on my hanger in my closet.
Playing Nerf basketball.
Meanwhile, Gasol.
We're going to look at it again. This kid gets up. Another one of those from Maywood, Illinois. Same hometown as Doc Rivers and Michael Finley. Went to the same high school as those guys, Proviso East. In fact, Shannon Brown's father, police officer. Doc Rivers' late father, also a police officer. They knew each other. They worked on a force together as Garnett knocks that down. And Shannon Brown, just a tremendous athlete.
Outstanding dunker everywhere but the dunk contest.
Leave that to the little guy, Nate Robinson.
4.5 left here in the third. Kobe Bryant inside.
And Bryant will go to the free throw line.
All right, still, now you've got 4:29 remaining as Brown and the Laker bench has been terrific, helping them get this 17-point lead. But there's lots of time.
So, Mike, I would say better than terrific. 21 zip. That's a shutout. That's getting it done by the Lakers bench.
Well, they heard all about it after game four as we'll listen to a Doc Rivers huddle.
We're getting multiple stops. We're missing wide open shots. We're missing layups, all right? If we keep getting multiple stops, they're going to fall. All you got to do is apply the pressure. That's your job. They're comfortable. They're up 18.
That's what always the hope, the team trailing by big numbers. So for the other team, just relax a little bit. We see it happen so often during an NBA season. You just lose your edge, and sometimes it's difficult to get it back. So far, the Lakers haven't lost their edge. Rondo looking. Shot clock down to 4. Odom on Ray Allen. Ray Allen steps back, puts it up. Knocks it down, a two-pointer for Ray Allen. He's got his shooting touch back tonight, 16.
Odom running the offense. Did you show the ability of Lamar Odom? He can run an offense. That's skills for a 6'10 player.
Bryant trying to get away from Allen. Rondo on the run. Pierce gets inside, trying to draw some contact. Can't get it. And here's Shannon Brown. Ball kicked. And a foul is going to be called. And it's going to go against Kevin Garnett. So Garnett picks up his second.
And pushed off there. Joe DeRosa right behind, making the call. That's the 14th foul.
Gasol wants the ball against Big Baby. Gasol's had a terrific all-around game. Rebound, shot blocking, passing. And Davis with the foul. So they're in the penalty now. And Pau Gasol will shoot. Three fouls on Big Baby.
And I just loved what happened right there. Kevin Garnett never lets you score after the basket. So he goaltended Gasol's shot. Lamar Odom then went up and got the rebound and tried to dunk it, and Garnett gave him a little shove. It's like a game within a game.
Gasol now with 10 points. Garnett always does this after the whistle. Won't allow the opponent to score. Even willing to take a foul. Gasol, 10 points, 9 rebounds, 5 assists, and 3 blocked shots.
Really, the Celtics' best matchup against Gasol is Perkins because of his size, his strength, his ability to force him to catch it away from the paint area. Gasol is living a life with no Perkins on the floor.
Rondo, the jump shot, gets that to go. Rondo just 4 of 12 from the field.
But they can get that shot anytime they want because they try to force those pick and rolls that take place on the side to the baseline. But because Bryant sags so far off Rondo, if they just put him in a couple pick and rolls, he'll get that elbow jump shot anytime he wants.
No,
and I really believe that Phil Jackson and Kobe Bryant, that's the strategy, so he can have that shot anytime he wants, and it's a strategy I agree with. Ron Artest bouncing back. He's got 12 points, back up to 19. Largest lead has been 22. Lakers have led almost the entire game. Rondo tried it a first time, didn't work. Good patience, and they get the layup.
A bad defense by Bryant, trying to overplay Rondo, allowing him to go back door. And good offense by KG and Rondo, reading each other.
Right back to Pau Gasol. Left-handed.
Oh, so impressive.
13 for Gasol. Big-time skill move. Rondo gets hit. Can't get it to fall. And now he'll go to the line. Kobe Bryant picks up his first foul. Kobe Bryant getting a lot of help tonight, Mark Jackson.
Pau Gasol taking him to school on the block. You don't help, you allow me to play one-on-one. Skilled with the left hand. And how about Shannon Brown in the Lakers bench? This is called my goodness. Great job of finishing and having an impact on the ball game.
As we welcome you back to Los Angeles, there's a good chance there'll be a Game 7, because right now here in Game 6, Lakers in complete control, up 19 with 2:03 remaining. If there is that Game 7, we'll have it for you back on ABC on Thursday night, tip-off shortly after 9 Eastern, and the NBA draft just around the corner as well on June 24th on ESPN. And the Lakers bouncing back again. We've said it over and over again. This team, they're a different team at home, and they were beaten badly, those two losses in Boston, but they've responded the way we thought they might.
They've gotten good balance tonight, but it's not because they're sharing the ball better. Their defense is better. Their rebounding is better, so they've had more transition opportunities.
Oh, you talk about it, Coach. It's amazing what happens when you play with force and with passion. Good things happen, and as a result, the Lakers are finding themselves running away with this game.
Rondo to the line. And that has been the real struggle for Rondo. Misses yet another free throw. And for Rondo, here in these NBA Finals from the free throw line, he's now 4-for-16.
I have never seen this. Ron Artest is on the inside position. Pau Gasol is in the third position.
And Davis gets the rebound. Not easy to get the rebound off a free throw miss for the opponent. And a big baby between those two.
I tell you what, I'm disappointed in Pau Gasol in that situation, because I don't know what the dialogue was, but it can happen. If I'm a seven-footer, get out my way and get in the third slot.
Farmar misses. Good defense from Wallace. Ray Allen brings it up. Vujicic made a nice play on him to knock it away after he secured the rebound. Vujicic can be such a pest defensively. Davis up to Rondo. Rondo again, giving the open jumper. About a foot short. Rebound Allen. Rondo this time, the floater. That won't go. Rondo now 5-for-15 from the field. And he's slow to get up down the other end. It's a 5-on-4. Vujicic. Bang! Lead is back to 22, largest of the night. And the Celtics call timeout as Rondo's shaken up. ...73-51 with 1:07 left in the third. He took a shot. Let's watch the play on the drive. Ron Artest with the hand up, whacked him right in the face.
And with a good play by Lamar Odom. Didn't stop, pushed the ball up the floor, and wound up with a high percentage shot. Not allowing Rondo to get up and come back and play defense. They played offense 5-on-4.
As we said earlier, this now equals the largest lead of the series of these finals by either team. The Lakers by 22. Doc Rivers' team so good on the road all season long. And again here in the playoffs. Struggling here tonight at Staples Center.
And I think when the Celtics look at this film from an offensive standpoint, Rajon Rondo is going to have to score big. in game seven because they are disregarding him more and more in the half court. He has open jumpers. He has driving lanes. And this guy's capable of having a big offensive game.
So Nate Robinson is checked in. And Artest reaches in. Call for the foul. Well, we talked about game four, the terrific performance from the Celtics bench, the Lakers bench tonight. Not only the numbers, but the energy, which was the same thing for Boston's bench in game four.
But, you know, I want to get back to what Coach just talked about. And Phil Jackson is doing the right thing. He's betting that Rondo is not going to win a seven-game series. So can he score big numbers? Absolutely. But we know for a fact that Paul Pierce and Ray Allen and Kevin Garnett can. They are allowing Rondo to take jumpers.
Pierce that time chucks up the three-pointer. Celtics just 3 of 14 from downtown. Final minute, third period. Gasol finds Artest. That's a three. It's good. 25-point lead for the Lakers. Nate Robinson tries to answer.
That's a bad shot. Had an opportunity to eat a lot of clock away and take the last shot. Instead, gives the Lakers another possession.
Farmar to Gasol has to go back. Puts up the jumper. Off the mark. Pierce the rebound. And the third quarter comes to an end. A dominant performance here in game six from Kobe Bryant and the Lakers. They're now one quarter away from forcing a game seven here in these NBA Finals. Bryant with 20. Gasol a near triple-double. Artest 15. And superb Laker defense. This presentation of the NBA Finals continues after this message and a word from our ABC station.
Welcome back to Los Angeles with Phil Jackson. How much of the difference in your team are tactical adjustments versus their approach?
Our defense is just tipping balls and getting guys to fumble balls, and we're coming up with the loose balls. It's such a big difference.
Like most benches, yours has been better here at home. Why is that so drastically different?
Aggressiveness. They come out, they feel comfortable, they're aggressive.
Phil, thank you. Mike.
In other words, they have been so aggressive. The Lakers as a team, so aggressive, like they had in game one. As you see the numbers by the bench, we said the same thing after game one of these NBA Finals. There was so much talk with the Lakers after what happened in 2008. Could they match the physical play? They did it in game one. That was what everybody was talking about. Wow, the Lakers are a different team. But then it started to turn and resort back to some of the things in 2008. Not the case here tonight in game six. Bryant, Shannon Brown, Odom and Gasol in there. Brown to force the turnover. Robinson dives. Farmar dives as well. And a quick whistle. And call a foul or jump ball. Yep, jump ball.
Rondo, you see wearing the Band-Aid after taking that shot to the chops by Ron Artest.
You know they have those race car races in arenas up on the Jumbotron?
Yeah.
And people bet which one. I think they should do that with jump balls. Like instantaneous. Who's going to win the jump ball? I'm picking Rondo on this one.
And you get a prize?
Yeah, I think they give pizzas away for the section that wins.
All right, so you're picking Rondo.
I'm picking Rondo. Although I'm not disregarding Jordan Farmar's athletic ability.
Take a wild guess who I'm picking if you're picking Rondo.
Players again jostling for position. You see Sheldon Williams in the game with Perkins out. Kendrick Perkins sprained his knee in the first quarter and will not return.
You owe me a pizza.
Pizzas for the Van Gundys. Robinson brings it up. Doc Rivers, there are four bench players in Rondo out there. Sheldon Williams getting time again. He only played in game two, limited minutes. Wallace misses. Gasol the rebound. That's 10 boards for Gasol. He's two assists shy of a triple-double. Odom And a hard foul from Rasheed Wallace. Wallace is perhaps going to play a huge role if there's a game seven, and there certainly looks like there will be one. You don't know the extent right now, the injury to Kendrick Perkins. So much depends on swelling and what happens overnight.
Now, you guys may say this is absurd planning, but if I was Doc Rivers, I would really think about taking Rasheed Wallace out right now and or putting him in the locker room to take away any possibility, as we see the injury to Kendrick Perkins again, to take away any possibility that he could possibly get entangled with his seventh technical foul and be suspended for the seventh game.
I'm a little concerned that I'm saying this, but I don't find that absurd at all.
I was checking my pulse because I felt the same way, Mike. First time this guy made some sense.
Foul called on Gasol. Again, it could be one of those things where, you know, they're frustrated. Obviously, they're getting waxed here tonight. You get involved in a little verbal jawing, and you pick up one of those silly double technicals, and then he'd be out for game seven. Minute gone by here in the fourth. Wallace and Rondo can't hold on.
And they continue just to roam off Rondo.
Wallace very aggressive with his defense. He's got four fouls. Bryant gets hit by Tony Allen. It's on the pass. And as the Celtics pick up their second team foul.
Now I'm going to tell you something. Looking at this Laker team tonight, it's a much easier group for a superstar to trust. The way that they're playing puts Kobe Bryant in position to be unselfish with the basketball and not try to win the game single-handed.
Well, overall this year, that's been the case. I mean, even look at game three of this series where Derek Fisher made some big plays, a host of players, as they got the win in Boston. Shannon Brown can't get it to go. But as you guys talked about, in game five, there was nobody that was really engaged during the course of that game. He took over in the third quarter because nobody else was doing anything.
Hey, their problem in that game was not offense. It was defense. They gave up 56% shooting. And, hey, if you're not getting stops, and Kobe Bryant's taking between 20 and 29 shots in every game. That's not an inordinate amount for a superstar scorer.
Tony Allen jump shot won't go. And Lamar Odom comes out with it. Odom's numbers, 8 points, 8 rebounds. Very good effort for Lamar Odom. Certainly needed it tonight.
The one thing I think Bryant should do, though, is sometimes it takes him too many dribbles to get off a quality look where the defense can just stare at it. Here tonight, he hasn't been in one of those dribble-a-thons.
That was the case a lot in game five as Nate Robinson gets inside. Nice reverse move for Robinson. And those are the first points from the Celtic bench. Still a 25-point game.
In those last three games, game three to me was the one where he took a lot of questionable shots, but they won that game, so it was overlooked. Games four, five, and tonight, to me, he's been tremendously efficient.
The incredible thing would be if the Celtics were to win tonight's game, Kobe Bryant would be the MVP of the series.
As the losing, no question. And any other vote would have been nuts.
Right, has it? Farmar spots up for three. In and out. Gasol right there to throw it down.
And I'll tell you why else it's easier to play. When you're up 20, it's easier to play well. And this is why the Celtics have to try to keep it close to see if these same guys who are making tonight will make when it's tight and tough in a game seven.
Bryant leads it up the other way. Odom. Odom's got a nice feel going right now. That won't go down. Rondo the rebound. Rondo just hasn't been sharp tonight. He has had just an unbelievable stretch run here in these 2010 playoffs. Well, nobody on the Celtics sharp. And a foul called outside as Nate Robinson is tripped up. They'll take a timeout. Pau Gasol, part of the excellent teamwork from these Lakers.
And you know what he says after the rebound, right? Pow! Punches it on Nate Robinson and crew.
ESPN's presentation of the NBA Finals on 8.
And Garnett and then Kobe Bryant both going from high school to the pros. In fact, we've got 4 of the 10 starters went right from high school to the NBA. In these NBA Finals, Garnett really reopened the door. It had been 20 years since somebody had made the jump. And because he handled it so well, Robinson way off, both on the court as a good player and his maturity off the court, it really opened the doors for a lot of other players to give it a try.
Here's my question watching that promo. Did Adam Sandler know that they were going to shoot that day? This guy had on green, blue, orange, tan, black, and white. Are you kidding me?
A turnover there by the Lakers. Tony Allen goes the other way, goes up and under, misses another layup. Robinson misses a layup, and Allen finally gets it to go. They missed about 5 layups here in this third quarter, and several of them early in the third when they were just trying to get back into it, and it really hurt. Barmore kicks it out. Odom left open. Tony Allen again on the charge. This is another one. Crowds relaxed a little bit, tired from all the cheering after their team went up by as many as 27. Shot clock down to 8. Bryant misses. Sheldon Williams has it. Robinson fires away. And Kobe Bryant with his 9th rebound of the game, going along with 20 points. Rebounding numbers 45-31. It just seems like it's a bigger margin than that. Lakers wisely taking time off the clock on the possessions. Farmar to the basket. Can't get it to go. Wallace the rebound. Ray Allen the drive. Gets inside. Gets it to go. Allen one of the few Celtics who've shot well. 18 points. Crowd trying to wake themselves up. Lakers have been up by double figures since the opening minute of the second quarter, and a technical foul call on Kobe Bryant. Off the steal by Allen, Bryant called for the technical.
And Bryant upset, felt like he was being grabbed, which he was, by Tony Allen. Picks up the technical foul, and Ray Allen going to the line to shoot it.
Well, I think he said one of those naughty words. So Ray Allen will shoot the technical. Celtics have only taken 7 free throws.
Mike, they only took, I think, 13 in the last game. So they're going to have to be offensively efficient. You have to get free throw attempts at the basket. You just do. It's hard enough to score two-point shot, because they're not going to get a lot of wide-open threes either.
6.5 remaining here in the fourth quarter. A surprising blowout. 21-point lead.
And I think this is interesting. Doc Rivers putting in Paul Pierce again, down 21, and playing him with Tony Allen, because a couple years ago, Tony Allen actually, with Rondo out, played as a starting point guard. I could see them going back to Allen instead of Nate Robinson on the road in game 7. And he's trying to get that unit some minutes together to see what might work.
Foul call on Ray Allen. And we'll have a timeout. Just at the midway point here in the fourth quarter. Lakers on the verge of tying the finals at 3 games apiece.
Thanks for watching ESPN on ABC, home of the NBA Finals.
Continues. Rajon Rondo now on the bench. His team down 21 with 6:05. Bill Jackson said at the start, curtailing his activity was crucial.
And they've done it even more tonight by totally disregarding him when he has the ball. Here, 17 feet away, which allows Bryant to be in position to rebound it. And then on a switch, Lamar Odom not even trying to contest the free throw line jump shot. Then on the air ball, he gets another chance, not guarded and hit with a vicious elbow by Artest. And then again, Rasheed Wallace in the post. Jordan Farmar roaming around, playing free safety off him. I really think going into game seven, they have to get Rondo in transition more. The only way to do that is to defend, rebound, and get him in the open court like they did in game two.
Rebounding has been a problem tonight. Fisher dribbles it off his leg. They'll get it back. You know, we just saw that golf and World Cup promo together. How about this for an idea? You know those Vuvuzelas at the World Cup? How about have them for the golf tournaments? You're allowed to bring them to the golf tournaments.
All I know is when I watch the World Cup, that's annoying. I don't know what it is, like if it's some tradition or whatever, but it's annoying.
Wallace. That won't go.
I mean, that'd be like those thunder sticks being constantly played in an NBA arena all game.
But they say those things can actually cause permanent hearing loss. Kobe Bryant gets in. Bryant with 22 points, 10 rebounds. And the Lakers have mauled the Celtics here tonight with 5.5 remaining here in the fourth. Puts up a three. Rasheed Wallace, 0 for 7 from the field, 0 for 6 from downtown.
Coach, you made a great point a couple minutes ago about Tony Allen playing the point guard position with Rondo out, and Doc Rivers trusting him in game seven. You see on the floor, before Big Baby comes into the ball game, he has Wallace, Pierce, Garnett, Allen, and also Tony Allen. So you can tell he's trying to establish a rhythm with that group.
And I liked Rasheed Wallace's shots tonight. And you made the point earlier that they're a harder team to guard when he's on the floor. And good play by Tony Allen right there.
Excellent block and then the foul call. The second time, Allen gives a look at Kobe Bryant. He gets up, a little shove with Lamar Odom. The initial defense was excellent. I don't know if that's a foul on Tony Allen. Doc Rivers certainly doesn't think so. Allen walks all the way down the other end of the court.
Well, Tony Allen is one of, if not the best on-ball defender, he's in the top five of wingmen in this league. That was terrific individual defense right there.
In the league, huh?
From the wing position, yeah. There's not five better on-ball defenders.
He's done a very good job. Even Kobe Bryant has complimented his defense. There's a lead back up now to 25. Under 5 minutes remaining. Ray Allen can't finish. He thought he was hit. And Odom with another rebound. His 10th of the game. First double-figure rebound of the finals for Odom. This is that. Gasol tips it out. Artest able to track it down. You're allowed to go back and get it on the tip. Gasol inside. Bryant. Garnett tripped up. That'll be the 14th foul. And Duke Walton's going to come in. Well, Doc Rivers will have to rally his team to get him ready for game seven. He was on that Nick team back in 94. Now, he was hurt, didn't play in the playoffs, but he was a member of the Nick team that was up 3-2 in the 94 finals heading to Houston. And then the Rockets won game six and seven at the old Summit in Houston. Meanwhile, Marquise Daniels makes a rare appearance. He hasn't played much, especially since that concussion in the conference finals. Paul Pierce is done for the night.
Certainly good to see Marquise Daniels on the floor.
An ovation for Odom. 8 points and 10 rebounds. And part of that excellent held the Celtics to 33% shooting. Remember, this came after a game where they shot 56%. So all bench players out on the floor for the Celtics as Daniels hits a three-pointer. A rare three-pointer that goes in. They're 4 of 20 tonight.
And Mike, that's why if I'm Phil Jackson, with under 4 minutes to go in a game that I'm clearly winning and I'm going to win, I'm taking out Pau Gasol and Kobe Bryant. We saw earlier, one play could change the entire series. Perkins goes down. You don't want to see that happen to Bryant Pau Gasol.
Although the crowd happy, he's still in the game. Pretty move from Bryant. 26 points, 11 rebounds. A total domination tonight here in Game 6. Sheldon Williams having his troubles and then fouls Fisher. We mentioned the 26 for Bryant, but he had plenty of help tonight in a number of different ways. Odom again, just the 8 points, but he had 10 rebounds. The bench was just terrific. Their energy, their defense. You see the plus 16 for the Laker bench. And Gasol just one assist shy of a triple-double. 17 points, 13 rebounds, and 3 block shots. And Bryant's going to get a huge ovation here. He was ornery after the Game 5 loss, as you would expect. There was talk that he gave a very positive speech to the team in the locker room after the game. Now, when he met with the media, he was not happy, rightfully so. Tried to tell his team, come back, we've got 2 home games, as Nate Robinson is the 3. And now it's going to be just 1 home game left. Game 7 here at the Staples Center. And as we said at the top, it's why the regular season has such importance. The Lakers will get the Game 7 on their home floor. Walton comes up short. Davis the rebound.
How great is that going to be? One game for all the marbles.
Especially with these two teams, Mark. For the 5th time in the history of this rivalry, the Celtics and Lakers will play a Game 7 in the NBA Finals. All Lakers tonight here in Game 6. To Farmar. Farmar inside. Oh, what a finish. Shannon Brown. Wow. A different Laker team here in Game 6. In Los Angeles, the Laker fans, a big sigh of relief as they are going to force a Game 7. We'll have it for you on ABC Thursday night. Tip off shortly after 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific. Kobe Bryant and the Lakers do what they had to do. Get one win and get another game. It's going to be only the 3rd time in the last 21 years the NBA Finals have gone to a Game 7. You mentioned 94 Knicks Rockets. The other one was 2005 Spurs and Pistons. Bulls all those years when they won championships never had a Game 7. Always wrapped it up in 6. As Daniels gets inside, DJ Benga gets in and quickly commits a foul. We're going to have another game in these finals where the rebounding winner wins. So it's the team that's won the rebounding battle, 6-0. And Jeff, we mentioned this earlier, the team that won the first quarter is 6-0. You've always been a big proponent of how important the first quarter is. We get so caught up in crunch time, but sets the tone often.
First quarter league, and like you said, how you start is oftentimes how you finish. And when you're playing with a cushion, as there's an anti-Boston chant, I love saying that. Oftentimes, you know, it's how you finish. And you establish that cushion and the demeanor of the game. And they did right off the bat tonight with not only aggressive rebounding, but they were aggressive at both ends, taking the ball to the basket and then preventing the Celtics from getting to the basket.
And you see the rebounding numbers, again, so important. And Pat Riley, what was his line always about rebounding?
No rebounds, no rings.
Why didn't he, you knew it. Why did he have to beg you to say it? About rebounds? I mean, you just knew right away.
I like the way he says it. He says it with such conviction.
And it's so true, though. You know, sometimes we always talk about, you know, this offense or that defense. Sometimes the game is decided when the ball's in the air. Do you want to go get it, whether it's in the air or on the floor, or are you going to spectate and watch?
Under 2 minutes remaining.
Now, the Celtics are a team that have bounced back to four from bad losses in these playoffs. Remember, in the conference semifinals, they lost at home by 29 to Cleveland. It was the worst home playoff loss in franchise history. Put them down 2-1 of the series. They came back and obviously beat the Cavs. Then in the next round against Orlando, they got whacked by 21 in game five and came back and won to wrap up the series in six games. So they have bounced back after poor performances throughout this postseason.
Right, and as much as everybody's going to talk about, you know, the Lakers offense, they're scored 89 points. This was about defense and rebound domination tonight.
Right from the start.
Kobe Bryant and the Lakers will go to 10-1 now at home in the playoffs. Again, the only home loss in this postseason was game two here in the finals. As they bounce back after those two straight losses in Boston, and Laker fans delighting in every second of it. Well, I guess this is their version of the beat LA chant. A little shot clock malfunction, so they'll inbound.
It'll be interesting to see in the game seven. As a coach, you don't have to cry out. You don't have to give any big-time speeches. You don't even have to tell them what's going to win. Each team understands what it's going to take, who is going to go out next to
you. DJ Benga, the rebound, and the final minute. So it's all going to come down to just one game. The NBA's two most successful franchises, the NBA's last two NBA champions, will treat us to a game seven on Thursday night. Ball battered around, picked up by Robinson.
And think about going into that game if you're Doc Rivers, having to start a new starting lineup, quite possibly with Kendrick Perkins being out.
Perkins, if you're tuning in late, sprained his knee in the first quarter. It looked serious. Did not return. Whether or not he's able to play on Thursday will be determined, obviously, in the next 48 hours. And the Laker fans celebrating. They were fired up but a little nervous coming into the game after two consecutive losses. They're back in the comfort of their home here at the Staples Center. Vujicic with the steal, and there'll be a game seven in the 2010 NBA Finals. A tough night to sleep for the Celtics as Pau Gasol and the Lakers. A great defensive effort. In fact, the second lowest point total in the NBA Finals as the Celtics lose 89-67. Kobe Bryant, superb once again. He's with Doris.
Kobe, for 2 days you have been beating the defensive drum. Tonight you hold the Celtics to an NBA Finals low 67 points. What about your defense made them so uncomfortable?
Well, we did a great job. You know, we blew too many assignments in Boston, gave them a lot of layups, and, you know, just too many points in the paint.
You have not won back-to-back games in this series to this point. It will take that in game seven. What has to happen?
Well, you know, we have to come with the same energy, you know, same dedication to the defensive end, and, you know, obviously cleaning up the glass.
Kobe, thank you very much. Mike.
All right, Doris. He's now one win away from his fifth NBA championship. But so are the Boston Celtics. And game seven will be back here at the Staples Center. We'll have it on ABC. Tip off shortly after 9. Kobe Bryant, the Lakers come home and once again put on a show. An impressive, dominant performance from start to finish.
led by double figures most of the way as they pound the Lakers and tie the series at three games apiece.